Good morning from the ICNMD 2018 in Vienna. We have just heard a wonderful lecture about amyotrophic lateral sclerosis from Professor Vandenberg. And he mentioned the importance of environmental factors. As you know, we have the World Brain Day this year.
Yeah.
And I would like to ask you, what can you tell us about environment and amyotrophic lateral sclerosis?
Yeah, we know about the sporadic form of ALS from twin studies that there's a contribution of genes, is about 60%. The contribution of environmental factors and lifestyle factors is 40%. And so we're investigating that in population-based studies. And we recently found that for ALS, we're using a residential history of patients and control group, and we found that in ALS patients there's more exposure to long-term exposure of air traffic pollution, so that's an indication that it increases the risk for ALS. So that's an important finding. We're also looking at environmental factors in occupational environmental factors, so we're looking using job exposure matrices. We apply that to our patients and controls, and we found that the exposure to silica is also a risk factor for ALS. So those are the environmental factors. We also have some lifestyle factors. Of course, smoking is a risk factor for ALS, and there's also some protective factors, like alcohol use seems to be somewhat protective.
Very good.
Not too much, but a little bit could be protective. And there are some other potential risk factors also in medical history, like head trauma seems to be a risk factor as well. And there's also some other lifestyle factors that could be related to hypermetabolism. So we see an energy-rich, high-calorie diet before patients are diagnosed with ALS. So if they have a higher calorie, but they have a lower BMI, hypermetabolism that we're studying now as well.
And you do study this in the large cohort, right?
Yeah, we're studying that in a case control cohort, population-based cohort in the Netherlands, and in collaboration with the population-based cohorts in Ireland and in Italy, with Ola Hardeman and Adriana Keel.
Congratulations. Yeah. How many patients do you have included in the study?
So it's 1,500 patients and about 2,500 controls. So it's large studies in different countries.
Very good.
And we're trying to expand those studies.
I was going to say, if you need the help of the World Federation, in finding
we need all the help to find the
Okay. Well, thank you very much for this interesting information.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you too.
Great.